What's up, everybody? My name is Jordan.
My name is Bree.
And this is Youth One. Now, we are episode four.
Number four.
So exciting. Guys, if you have a chance, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, and definitely make sure to hit that notification bell because we're uploading content every week, and we hope that it helps you throughout your week. We're talking about how to become bully-proof today, right? And I'm excited about it because we're going to leave you with two very practical steps that you can just start applying today and start practicing it. And ultimately, we hope that it helps you end the bullying cycle in your life. Yeah. Bree, have you ever, you know, been bullied in your life?
Oh, yes. Yeah. I have been bullied.
Haven't we all,
pretty much my whole life. I was homeschooled, and because I was homeschooled, I got bullied. And even when I went to high school, like an actual school, I was bullied too because I told them, oh, yeah, I was homeschooled before. And they just like, just started bullying me about that. And I didn't do anything. I didn't know I did anything wrong. And it made me feel little, made me feel small. And I didn't know what to do. What about you? Have you ever been bullied, Jordan?
Yeah, I specifically remember a time at summer camp because, you know, we spent 5 days in a cabin, you know, where you like slept overnight and stuff. And every single night, these kids were making fun of my mom. And I just remember, you know, with a pillow over my head, trying to just mute everybody out. And I cried myself to sleep. And it sucked. And I ended up having to leave halfway through the week because I just couldn't handle it anymore. So we know what it feels like to be bullied, you guys. We still go through this every day online. You know, there's so much of it going on. And it's so accessible. It's so easy to do. And so we hope this helps you today, at least in a practical way, in starting to apply this different these different steps in your life. So the first thing I want to do actually, though, is understand this game that we call bullying, right? And it is a game because there's always a point to what the bully is doing. They have a goal and you have a goal when it comes down to bullying. The number one goal for the bully is to hurt your feelings, is to hurt you, right? That's what it's always broken down to. And there's this old adage that says, hurt people.
Hurt people.
Hurt people, hurt people, right? They've been hurt themselves. And so they're trying to deflect that to somebody else. And it's not right. They shouldn't be doing it. But that's ultimately why it comes down to why they're hurting you or trying to hurt your feelings. And so that's their number one goal, is to hurt your feelings. Now it comes to you. What's your number one goal when it comes down to being bullied? And that's to be resilient.
What does resilient mean?
It's a great question. And I'm going to say it in the forms of when it comes down to bullying, is resilience ultimately is not letting your feelings get hurt.
Gotcha.
Right? They're telling you these things, they're making fun of you, whatever. And you're taking this all in, and it ultimately comes down to is not letting those things bother you, right? That's what we talk about when we talk about resilience. And so that's your number one goal. Okay, so the number one step that you need to do when you're getting bullied is act calmly. Just like that. Such a good example. You need to breathe, right? Because what's going to happen is how you act is going to determine their reaction. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, that's good.
So how you respond determines how they're going to respond back to you. And so if you act aggressively back to them, it's just going to be this constant battle of hate, 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 hate. And it usually ends up with somebody getting punched.
Yeah.
Right? But if you act calmly and act calmly in the situation and respond in a calm way, eventually the bully is going to move on because you're not giving in.
Right.
You know, your feelings aren't getting hurt. You're not giving in. And it's going to mean nothing to them, and they're going to eventually move on, right? So here's point number two, really quickly, is you need to activate love, right? Remain calm, activate love. And this sounds a bit crazy, you guys. It sounds a little weird. It sounds a little bit off. But if you actually act in love towards the other person continually, even if they're hating on you all the time, eventually they feel the need to either move on or to respond in the same way.
Right.
Comes back. It's called the law of reciprocity. Okay. It's like reciprocating something. And the law of reciprocity, all it says is the more you do something continually, the same thing, like an emotion, is subconsciously that person feels like they have to do the same thing in return. It's like mirroring that thing. And so if I continue to act in love towards somebody, when they continue to hate me, eventually they feel the need to just move on because they're giving up, or to just be more friendly and kind to me.
Yeah.
right? Mm-hmm. And so it comes back to the quote by Martin Luther King Jr. in saying, darkness cannot drive out darkness, only light can do that. And the same thing is, hate cannot drive out hate, only love can do that, right? Yeah. So next time you're getting bullied, remember, act calmly and activate love. Mm-hmm. It takes a lot of practice, you guys. It is the toughest thing to do, but if you focus on those two things, I guarantee it's gonna end the bullying cycle in your life. Mm-hmm. If you wanna look at these notes, we've added them in the bio section. You can rewind and see all these notes to review to make sure that you're doing this the right way. But let's quickly talk about, before we end, about if you're getting punched, if somebody steals your stuff, or if somebody wrecks your stuff. You guys, if that's happening to you, that's actually not what we're talking about right now. If somebody is beating you up, that is assault. Mm-hmm. If somebody steals your stuff, that's theft.
Yeah.
If somebody wrecks your things, that's vandalism. In all those cases, you need to make sure somebody knows and the right authorities are contacted mm-hmm. for that, because that is just not allowed to happen and that's completely out of your control. Mm-hmm. But what we are saying is, what is in your control are your emotions and how you respond to those things. So it always sucks when somebody's bullying you. You can be mad about it. You can just be raging inside. But remember, how you respond is gonna determine the result of what's going on.
Exactly.
And so we wanna make sure you guys know that. Guys, we hope this helps you. We know it's helped for us. And we just wanna make sure that you're doing okay, that you know that somebody's here for you. We love you. Mm-hmm. If you live in Lethbridge and you're going through this right now and you just want somebody to talk to, let us know. Come by Youth One. It's always together is better. Having mm-hmm. that community makes things so much better. And so if you live in another city, if you live across the country, make sure you surround yourselves with people in your lives that are adding that positive impact to your life. It's going to make things so much better. And try this too. You know, next time this happens to you, try it and let us know what the result was. It takes practice, but keep on working on it. And we really hope this helps you out. Okay, we'll see you guys next time. Great talking to you.
See you guys.
Have a great weekend.